It's not. Test.
Wait a second, I need to find another mic.
I think that your computer maybe, I don't know.
Oh.
This one?
No.
Okay, let's wait here. One sec. Try this. What is that? It won't turn on.
It's not detected here.
Do you need another adapter?
Okay, wait.
Wait a second, my mic turned on. And P extend. Give me a second.
Finally, eh?
Don't have to login. It should show it work in Siri. You don't need to screw everything because.
Okay, good.
Okay, it's on. You want to duplicate a mirror. Mirror or extend. Mirror may be better. Windows and P, yeah.
Okay, just... Okay, good afternoon. Now... Okay, hello everyone.
大家好.
Today I will presenting about the wireless management system in MikroTik.
今天我要讲关于管理 MikroTik 的无线系统.
So, I will combine with some business prospect in another country.
他将讲解在他们国家的一些商业实例.
Okay, let me introduce myself.
现在我介绍一下我自己.
I was on behalf of NetData here.
我个人代表 NetData 公司.
NetData, yeah. I working for network monitoring, pre-sales and SDN.
我个人工作于网络监管, 授权服务和软件定义网络.
I'm also a MikroTik certified consultant and engineer.
同时也是 MikroTik 认证的咨询师和工程师.
Yeah, I'm coming from Jakarta, Indonesia.
我来自印度尼西亚的雅加达.
I'm sorry, I cannot speak Mandarin. I'm sorry, I cannot speak Mandarin.
很抱歉，我不会讲普通话.
So, this is some of my contact. I'm welcoming you also from WeChat.
现在屏幕上是我的一些联系信息，我也可以在微信上和你们沟通.
Yeah, if you need anything, just catch me up.
如果你需要任何信息，可以直接添加我.
Okay, and then we'll talk about the opportunity, and then why we using MikroTik, and then the technical things, and how we can monetizing.
这个演讲主要是关于 opportunity.
Yeah, we will talk about why we using MikroTik. Why the technical things?
这个研主要是关于为什么我们选择使用 MikroTik 的产品，以及其中遇到的一些困难。
And study case that I been made in Indonesia.
以及我们在印度尼西亚的一些实际案例。
Okay. So the background is Indonesia have many citizens that using the internet.
关于整个演讲背景是印度尼西亚有两亿多的居民。
More than half of Indonesia citizen using the internet.
超过半数的居民都在使用互联网。
So you can imagine how if you implement some opportunity in China. Okay.So China has the biggest population in the world. So yeah, there's so many opportunity that you can get.
中国有现在世界上最多的人口，我们希望能在中国有一些机会。
Or from China, expand your business to Indonesia.
或者从中国扩展你的生意到印度尼西亚。
So why MikroTik?
为什么使用 MikroTik 的产品
？Yeah, MikroTik is everywhere and easy to buy. You can buy from any distributor here.
MikroTik 的产品随处可以买，在印度尼西亚也可以买到。
And then MikroTik have a rich of feature. There are so many feature in MikroTik.
MikroTik 产品也有很丰富的功能。
Yeah, you can run many feature of it, like routing, switching, wireless.So many things in there.
像路由、防火墙等等，很多功能都包含的。
And the most important is the price. It's really affordable.
最重要的是它的价格非常的合适。
Yeah, you can compare with another product that can run the rich feature like a MikroTik.
你可以比较一下其他公司有相同功能的产品。
Yeah, starting from around $20.
最便宜的产品只需要$20。
Yeah, you can run off all of MikroTik feature.
你就可以使用 MikroTik 的所有的功能。
So, we are getting in to the Capsman.
接下来我们讲一下 Capsman.
Capsman is the wireless management system on the MikroTik.
Capsman 是 MikroTik 产品上的AP 管理系统。
Yeah, you can control your access point based on MikroTik.
你可以管理所有 MikroTik 的 AP 产品。
And you can see here, Capsman is where's the okay? Capsman is a controlled access point system manager.
Capsman 是一个中央的无线网络管理软件系统。
So you will have a centralized management to all of your access point.
所以你可以在一个地方管理你所有的 AP。
And minimum configuration on your access point.
也只需要极少的配置。
Okay, this one.
这是 Capsman 的全称。
Yeah. And then why Capsman?
为什么选择使用 Capsman?
You can doing data processing. Yeah, some manipulation on, yeah.You can manage the data process, the data path.
使用 Capsman 你可以控制并修改数据。
And then you can control all of MikroTik device at least with one or single wireless interface.
你也可以控制哪怕只有一个无线端口的 MikroTik 产品。
And you can auto discovery your device.
你也可以自动发现你的设备。
So you doesn't need to add one by one.
所以你不需要手动一个一个的添加。
And there is no additional hardware required.
也不需要采购额外的硬件。
For example, you need to install the controller on another server and control your access point. So if you using the MikroTik, you can using the controller of on the MikroTik itself.
如果你已经有一个 MikroTik 产品，你可以在这个 MikroTik 产品管理你其他的 AP。
Yeah, it's a centralized, and then it can be placed anywhere. At least it's reachable. At least it was reachable by the IP address or the layer 2 communication.
你也可以把它放置在任何地方，包括你也可以使用 IP 直接去连接管理它。
Yeah, and then it was based on a router OS, and there is no additional license or there is no additional cost.
它是基于 router OS 的产品，所以没不需要额外的授权，也没有额外的花费。
Yeah, really affordable.
就是非常的，怎么说呢？性价比很高吧。
Okay, you can also combine some feature like VLAN, roaming, bridging.
你也可以混合使用其中的一些功能，比如像 VLAN、无线漫游等等。
Yeah, access list, data processing, auto provisioning.
还有像访问控制、数据处理以及自动发现。
Load balancing, security properties, channel properties, and many more.
也可以对 AP 进行负载均衡以及设置安全和频道的属性。
And then, this is the basic CAPsman setup.
这是一个非常基础的 CAPsman 设置。
You can have one router here, and then let's say I have two access points here.
你可以有在这里有一个路由器以及两个 AP 节点。
Or actually, you can use your access point as your CAPsman also. You can use your access point as your CAPsman also.
你也可以在你的 AP 上运行 CAPsman.
Yeah, so it can be placed anywhere.
所以它可以被放置在任何地方。
Yeah, this is the basic setup. Actually, this is the command line.
这是一些基本设置的命令。语句
but the simple things you can read from my comment is this is only create one bridge interface.
这些命令里创建了一个 bridge.
And then I create a DHCP server there.
然后我创建了个 DHCP 服务器。
Yeah. And then I have the bridge interface, I have the IP address, I have the DHCP server.
在这里我设置了桥，设置了网络地址以及 DHCP 服务器。
So my network was ready, and then just enable the CAPsman here.
所以当网络准备好以后，直接启用 CAPsman.
So simple.
就简单的一行命令。
And then this is the configuration on your access point.
这是你在 AP 节点的配置。
So you only need to define your CAPsman address, and then, or if you want to discover by the L2 communication, you can define the discovery interface.
你可以在这里直接设置你的 CAPsman 地址，也可以打开自动发现。
And enable, yes, and then define the interface that you want controlled by your CAPsman.
启用 CAPsman 功能，然后指定想要被管理的无线接口。
Yeah, you can see here. If the interface was controlled by the CAPsman, you cannot configure anything on your wireless interface.
在这里你可以看见，如果你的无线接口已经被 CAPsman 控制了，你在这里无法修改它的配置。
Because all of the configuration is on your CAPsman, not on your access point anymore.
因为所有的配置都是由 CAPsman 下发的，并不是在 CAPs AP 上配置的。
Yeah, it's centralized.
所以是中央化管理的。
Okay, this is the CAP interface. This is the interface that define on each wireless interface on your CAPsman.
这里是你在 CAPsman 上可以看到你的 AP 的每一个无线接口。
So this one wireless CAP interface is for one wireless interface on your CAP.
CAP AP 上的每一个接口在 CAPsman 上也是一个接口。
But this menu is on your CAPsman.
但是这个界面只可以在你的 CAPsman 上去管理。
So, we can do a manual config. When the CAP is detected by the CAPsman, you can configure manually.
我们也可以手动去设置 CAPsman.
So I create one configuration template here.
所以我在这里创建了一条配置。
I define the channel band, channel width, frequency, the country, the data path. the mode, the name, and then the my SSID.
定义了频段、频宽、频率，国家以及 SSD 名等其他信息。
And then I apply the my configuration to all my cAP interface.
然后我将这个配置信息应用到了我的所有的 AP。
By the single line of a command, you can apply to all your interface.
只需要一行命令，你就可以把这个配置应用到所有的 AP 上。
Sorry, I mean your cAP interface.
我是指 AP 的接口。
Or you can automatically deploy your config to your cAP based on properties that you can define in provisioning menu.
你也可以在自动发现里去自动下发你的配置到 AP 里。
You can see the MAC address, so the capsman will identify your access point by the MAC address.
你在这里可以看到我设置了一个 MAC 地址，所以 capsman 可以根据 MAC 地址来判断是 AP 节点。
Also can by the identity, the router identity.
也可以通过路由的 ID 来选择 AP。
And see the action here. You can create, enable, and then choose the configuration template that you already made before.
在这里你可以看到我在 action 里启用了这个规则，并指定了配置文件。
Yeah, automatically is pretty easy.
所以很简单，都是自动的。
So this is one of my production is on Surabaya. Is one of Indonesia city.
这是我现在正在运行一个生产环境的截图。
I have around 28 MikroTik access point here.
我大概有28个 MikroTik 的 AP.
And I have one router as for my capsman.
我有一个路由器上运行着 capsman.
So this is the user that already connect to my wireless network. There's around maybe 50 or 100.
这是所有连接到我 AP 上的用户列表，大概有50 to 100个用户。
Yeah, pretty good. Because you can monitor all of it from one dashboard only.
你可以在一个面板上看到所有的信息。
So and then how we can monetizing the access point, and the simple question is the MikroTik hotspot. We can put the some advertising or design your business model there.
所以我们如何使用 CAP AP 来盈利呢？就是使用 MikroTik 的 hotspot 功能，可以在上面打一些广告。
Or you can create some survey to gain the data.
你也可以去尝试获取一些用户的问卷调查来取得信息。
Yeah, for the example from China is a OK portal, you know.
在中国有个产品叫 OK portal.
Yeah, there's so many product from there's so many product that similar like a marketing hotspot that can build new business model.
有很多和 hotspot 类似功能的产品。
So this is the setup of the hotspot. It's really simple. You can just run IP hotspot setup, and that's it.
这是一个简单的 hotspot 设置，只需要运行 IP hotspot setup 即可。
And then you can customize your landing page and put some ads there.
你也可以自定义你的登录页。
Here's for the example I got from a search engine on internet.
这是我在网上搜索到的一些案例截图。
They advertise the food. Oh, everything is food.
Yeah, 都是一些食品的广告。
Yeah. Okay, and then I have some study case in Jakarta.
我有一些实际的案例。
I work for a network data system as a system integrator.
我在 network data system 工作，作为一个系统整合商。
We work with MacroAd to deploy free Wi-Fi service.
我们和 MicroAD 合作去部署免费的 WiFi 服务。
In commuter line, it's like the subway or metro in here.
在 KRL 通勤线上。
So the metro in Jakarta have around 1 million passenger each per day on weekday. Yeah, the number is really much.
KRL 每天可以达到有100万乘客左右，所以人数是非常多的。
Yeah, you have more than 1 million user per day that you can engage with your advertising or depend on your business model.
所以根据你的商业模型，你最多可以有100万的广告受众。
Yeah, this is the landing page that we create.
这是我们创建的登录页面。
And I helping the micro ad as the for the infrastructure.
我帮助 MicroAD 公司创建了这个。
Like the router and the Wi-Fi, how I can integrate the system.
比如像路由器 Wi-Fi 以及如何整合这些系统。
Okay, and then I have a little bit demonstration here.
我有一个简单的演示。
Okay. This is my production on Surabaya.
这是我的生产环境。
One of city in Indonesia.
是印度尼西亚的一个城市的。
This is a hotel.
是一个酒店的项目。
I have around 29 access point here.
有29个 AP 在运行。
You can see here, I didn't make any provisioning configuration.
我在这里没有添加任何的自动发现配置。
I just made one configuration template here.
我只是手动添加了一条配置在这里。
No channel, no data path, no security configuration, no access list, no rates. All of the configuration has been here.
只是在 configuration 里创建了一条配置，没有单独去设置频段、安全、访问权限控制等等。
And this is the access point that already connected to my capsman.
这是目前连接到 capsman 的所有 AP 信息。
Yeah, you can monitor the version, the serial, the MAC address, the state, the identity.
你可以在这里查看他们的版本、序列号、MAC 地址、状态等等。
Radio.
这是频设信息。
And then the client also.
以及所有连接的客户。
The one feature that I like is, you can see the signal.
我比较喜欢那个功能是在这里可以看到他们的信号强度。
Ah, yeah. If your client was complaining, you can see the signal on the single dashboard.
如果你有顾客在投诉，你可以在这里看到他们的所有的信号强度信息。
For example, I have one client here in lobby.
比如像现在在大厅有一个。用户
，the signal is not really good.
它的信号强度并不是非常好。
So you can use Capsman to monitoring it.
所以你可以使用 Capsman 去监测这些信息。
Yeah. And then I also have the hotspot. Wait. I have a hotspot also here.
我有一个 hotspot 的设置。
I define on the bridge interface.
我在桥接的端口上进行的设置。
So yeah, this so I bridge all of this cAP interface.
所以我把这些的所有的 AP 接口全部桥接在了一起。
To one single bridge.
桥接到了一个桥上。
So I just need to configure the IP address.Hotspot and the DHCP on one single bridge interface only.
所以我可以把像 Hotspot、DHCP 等服务全部配置在一个桥上。
Yeah, it's pretty easy.
设置起来很简单。
Okay. Wait. You can see here.
在这里你可以看到。
I define the bridge interface here.
我在这里定义了要桥接的桥。
So every cAP interface that I define the configuration.
所以每一个我下发了配置的 AP.
With bridge interface, the cAP interface will join the bridge interface.
他们的无线接口都会加入到这个桥接接口内。
So it automatically join the in the same network in the same broadcast domain.
所以他们会自动的处于一个发现域里。
And then you can configure like the hotspot or the DHCP as what you want on your network.
所以你可以在你的网络里随意的设置像 DHCP 以及 hotspot.
Okay. Yeah, simple.And then back to the presentation.
回到 PPT.
I have some reference for you. Want to study more?
我有一些引用资料，如果你们想了解更多。
You can refer to the wiki.microtik.
你可以查看 MikroTik 的维基信息。
Or see some of MikroTik user meeting presentation study case.
以及 MikroTik 其他的一些演讲等等。
Like my presentation here.
就像我今天的演讲。
So, if you have any question, you can leave us a message. This is my email. Or if you want to chat me on my WeChat, I will reply your message because.My daily job, I also handling some client from Guangzhou, so you can contact from my WeChat.
如果你有问题，你可以给我发邮件，也可以添加我的微信。我在广州有一些客户。
So, you have any question? You can ask me.
如果你有任何问题，你可以向我提问。
I still have any time.
还有一些时间的。
So yeah, if you have any question, you can ask me here, or you can leave me email or chat me on my WeChat.
如果你有问题，你也可以稍后向我发邮件或者添加微信询问。
So I think that's it of my presentation. 谢谢。